Hey everybody, this is LuigiFan64, and welcome back to Let's Play Majora's Mask Redux, episode number 6. Now, when we last left off, we intentionally fast-forward to day 3, so they can, open up the pass to Romani, so we can get the Winnie Hood. So, right now we have to do the final minigame in the Deku Scrub stuff. We don't have to, but I want the heart piece. I think I have, like, two, so we'll go for 3. Whee! Okay. I'm gonna state here, and the reason being is the emulator's a little weird, because it still has that kind of like lag that you kind of see in 64. The B116. For some odd reason, the timer doesn't, unlike the actual console version of the game. Timer actually doesn't slow down when the game kind of slows down a little bit. I don't know if anybody would know what I'm talking about, but I don't know, I just kind of feel that way. Maybe I'm just terrible at this game now. But yeah, I just, I've been kind of, sitting here a little bored. And, I'm gonna fall. I downloaded the Five Nights at Freddy's demo for the second one. Just nothing better to do, I guess. I mean, that game's not creepy at all. Like, it's not scary. Actually, the only person I've ever seen walk through the games, like, since the second one's already out, is just Markiplier, and that's just because he's, like, the only person I can tolerate. I mean, Sorry. Drinking some rum chata. Tastes delicious. Such a useful face. And then they run away every time I come in. But yeah. I've only ever seen Markiplier. So me and my brother got in a discussion of how he's not like PewDiePie. And I'm bringing him up again. I don't know why. But it's like, they're the same. I'm like, I don't know. He's a little bit more tolerable. I think so, at least. I mean, I don't know what any of you think of Markiplier. I'm not subbed to him or anything on YouTube, though, so it's like, I guess I don't care that much. But, you know, he's admitted to overreacting on the game with the scares and stuff, and hell, even the guys down at Game Theory did the same thing. I'm looking at you, Matt Pat, who's not subscribed to me. Ooh! Dang it, I'm being all sorts of rude today. Scoosie. Well, anyways, like you saw, we got the heart piece in the Deku minigame. Heart piece up there. I'm 100% sure I did the one on the toilet hand. I'm trying to remember what other ones we can do in this town right now. I'm not 100% sure. It's not coming to mind right now. There's one for the bank, but that's 5,000 rupees. I really don't remember if I actually did that one, though. Man. Oh, I think there's more heart pieces for the, in Woodfall, but we're on day 3. So, we're just gonna play the Song of Inverted Time. We'll just return the flow back to normal. Cause if I don't know which one I can do. It's a little risky with how many hearts I have right now, but so here in the north of Clock Town, we've got like the Dongos. You know, pretty easy bastards. These small ones take 4 slashes.
I think the big ones take 16 slashes, I'm not sure, but in these Zelda games, a jump attack is considered 2. Because I know with the gilded sword on these giant Dodongos, it's like, not too many slashes. And the Dodongos hurt, so 2, 4, 6. What we want is this one Dodongo to not bug us. Gotta take them on one at a time. Dang it. Alright. It's 12 slashes. If you're not explode, otherwise it might be part of some collateral damage. Fairly easy. A little boring, I know. But basic strategy for those who want to kill Dodongos without slashing individually. I mean, they're left so vulnerable after breathing fire. Whoa, okay, I was about to almost, like, let go. There we go. And they dropped 50 rupees, so that's 100 rupees for 2 Dodongos. So it's pretty damn useful, if you ask me. I mean, it's a good way to grind money, too. I mean, oh, okay, I didn't do it then. I thought I did in another video. There we go. Now we're at 5. Whoa. There's a lot more rum in that one than chata. I think that's it, because we can't get into the stone temple area. To the Ikana graveyard and all that.
I think we need a polymer for that one.
What else can we do right now? Got 5 hearts. Alright, I know what we're gonna do. So, I don't want those. We're going to deposit this stuff in the bank. Deposit rupees. I remember. I think he gives us the giant's wallet. I don't know. Oh, excuse me again. Jesus, guys. I'm sorry. There's a ton of rupees. He gives us the giant's wallet. I think at 1,000 rupees, I believe. I'm not 100% sure, but what we're gonna do right now, this kind of rupee grind. And the reason being for said rupee grinding is because the bank guy, you know, the bank here where we deposit our rupees and such, obviously, what else would a bank do? They give us a heart piece at 5,000, so it's probably one of the more time consuming slash kind of easy ways to get rupees, especially if there's like, say here in Clock Town, right above, after you pass the gallery minigame and all that, there's that chest with 100 in it, the giant Dodongos in, you know, north of Clock Town, and it's pretty much the rupees resetting in general on every, like, location, if you give it enough time. But the easiest ones are usually the hundreds, the silvers. Okay, so now I actually want to look at Majora for the tier so we can get some more rupees. And he's kind of just sitting there. I don't think he actually openly mocks us. Here. I don't believe so. Yeah, he just kind of sits there. Hey, he doesn't disappear either. moons, Tyrion. Let's go ahead and go give it to the Deku merchant. I know what you're thinking. But Luigi, get out of Clonk Town. Go to the next temple. We'll head there after this. I don't know what I'm doing. Oh yeah, that's right. I need decrements. Guys, how I fight skull shells. Help. Alright. Woodfall Temple is gonna be fun, because if I remember the last go through of this Majora LPI started like 6 years ago or something like that. I don't even know. I had like 7 hearts, I think, going on 2 heart pieces by that time. I don't remember, but once the bow is obtained in Woodfall, we can go back here and then do the mini games and stuff, because there's a bow and arrow one, a bomb, and a bomb chew one. Let's go ahead and give the Decker this. There you go, buddy. And then another kind of, it's not as hard. And another sense of heart pieces. There's the merchant swapping. So you give him the moon tier, and he gives us this deed. This one, which I so totally didn't mean to pull out, and then you give it to the one in Woodfall, and he gives you a deed, and the one from Woodfall goes here, and then you go to Snowhead, and you give him that deed, and blah 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 blah. You just pretty much go back and forth between all the Deku merchants, and you can use their flowers and gain access to heart pieces at that point. So here's 50 rupees. I keep hearing like footsteps. I think someone's home or something. 5 Nights at Freddy's demo, man, I'm telling you. Help! I'm falling, Captain! Fack. Whoa. Dog's an asshole. Yeah, okay, we're good here. There we go.
I think the guide is like, use the hookshot.
Well, I don't need, oh, it's just 20, I thought it was 100, god damn it. I wasted my time. I wasted all your time. Alright, let's go deposit this. Wait a minute. There is another, oh, I'm not gonna bother. There is another heart piece that we can get at all that much. Let's deposit my rupees real quick, man. $602. No, I don't want to pull out the title deed. God damn it. Okay. I think it really sucks with the Majora 3DS version coming out. Not that the game itself is coming out, but I just remember that my freaking, my fucking 3DS's L button is, like, busted, and, you know, I guess it's not a bad thing. It still works, you just kind of have to press it a little bit harder, but we got new 3DS models that are gonna come out soon, you know, improved processor, and a little mini C-stick kind of thing, and... Alright, guys, let's go ahead and get this started, shall we?
Let's get out of this town.
Slow down time. There's more access to heart pieces out in the world. Yo, son, I got a sword. That's my way. Alright, let's do this. I got this. Ha! Is there any way to... No. Oh, yeah, that's right. The cutscene starts up here. I think it's through the tunnel. Can't take it seriously with those ears on, Link. I just can't. I can't. You look silly. Oh, I remember this. Tail and I drew this with the Skull Kid when we first met him. He told us that he had not been fighting with his friends and that they had left them all alone.
It was a dark and stormy night. Tattle and Tail are out on their own in the rain, looking for shelter. And then they see it. A giant piece of log in the middle of the forest. They fly in relief that shelter has come upon them. As Tail shakes, Tattle comforts him, but then gasp!
A mysterious figure is shivering and shivering with the cold, but soon they become quick friends, keeping each other warm until the rain passes by. And it rains on the second day, which is kind of funny, but...
And such a friendship has blossomed.
You know, I always thought this, like, a little surprising when I first played this, because it was, like, you kind of saw the Skull Kid's faces in the Lost Woods in Ocarina, but it was just all blackened out, and, you know, their eyes and their mouth. I'm sure it was because he was always playing tricks, and nobody wanted to play with him, but to do what he did just because of that. Ambushing the Happy Mask Salesman. Once he got his power, I just don't know. Long story short, always friendly at one point. Bit of a mischievous person. Ended up being a douche. Douchebag. Bats! Oh fuck, there's another one! Come on. It kind of drives me a little crazy near the beginning of this game when I don't have my bow and arrow, because I gotta use the Deku and, you know, go through the whole putting on the mask and animation. Anyways, another heart piece hidden in this tree. I think there is a place. That lets us, use our bow and arrow, I believe. Really? Wow, I'm doing so bad right now. Sorry that I break your pottery, Brad, but I need some, hearts. I think this place actually lets me do the shooting gallery. Oi, mate! Oh, are ya? We'll play. One game's 20 rupees. Oh, okay. I can't. Never mind. I gotta come back. Jesus. Oh, yeah, that's the pattern, eh? Welcome forward, mate. So now we just got to go and... Let's do this first. I don't really use the maps in this game, but feel a sense of accomplishment when I have If I can just shoot him. Tingle, please. There we go. Pop a bubble with the bubble. God, Tingle's creeped me out so much. Alright, so these are Tingle's magic words. Don't steal them. Ah, the Southern Swamp. I hate this place. Just like, ugh. The music's good. I love it. Dun, dun, dun. Oh, Deku's Bros. Ah, there's the Deku Sticks. Okay. Another owl statue? Now let's go into the thingy for cameras. As they are, as in a harpies, I could have actually gotten the deed from them. Blowing me away is that old child is full point hooky again. Child his age has no business searching for fairies. Oh, look, it's Tingle's father. I don't have a camera. The Salt Tour Center is currently old enough for 12 pictograph contest. It's open to all ages, from children to adults. For nice photographs taken in the swamp, a free boat cruise will be awarded as a special prize. So would you like to enter our contest? Oh, but to enter, you first must take the boat cruise. Boat cruise reservations are handed over at that window there. If you're interested, go for a ride. But guess what? We can't, because it's handled by one of the Coem sisters. So now what we have to do is go to the sisters, so we go Deku! Ooh, I always like mistime it. Use the boost. Alright, let's head over to the potion shop. I'm just getting rupees at this point. Do I have to talk to her first, or can I just go? I don't know, we'll talk to her first, no big deal. A lot of silence in this episode, I don't need to be.
Welcome! My potions work very well, they do. Are you, by chance, a boat cruise customer? How unfortunate. Colm has gone into the woods out back looking for mushrooms.
Oh, god damn it. I pressed B by accident. Okay. So, the Woods of Mystery. This game's equivalency of the Lost Woods. And just as annoying. Gotta follow this little guy around. Stupid snapping turtles. So not too hard, really. Yeah. Should lead us to Colm. There she is.
I was busy minding my own business, picking mushrooms, when wham! Bam! I got hit from behind. That pesky skull kid, do you think an old hag wouldn't recognize him if he hit his face? Ow, ow, to think he's that powerful. And now I can't even move. You have anything that gives you energy?
We don't. Because we gotta go, now talk to Kotek and get the red potion and the bottle, or first bottle. Alright, let's wake her up again. Wakey wakey! Here it comes. Oh no!
What's that? The Skull Kid got to Cullen? That's ridiculous! If it's just the Skull Kid, then what harm could he possibly do? Oh, well, if that's true, then take this potion to her. This isn't good.
We've got a red potion! And a bottle! A red potion and a bottle! Now, let's go find her and give this to her. And
here's another thing. You can drink this potion by accident.
If your finger somehow, like,
hits whatever C button you have it on.
I did it once before. Nothing bad happens.
She just gives you another red potion and tells you not to drink it. Again. It's pretty funny, actually. And I think I did it when I was, like, actually running. Okay, it's this way. And I believe it's on the left. Yep. The path is... The path that you need to take... The monkeys lead you down are always different depending on the day. So if it's day one, it'll always be this path that you see. That you saw me take twice. Day two is a different path, and day three, same. And we can finally go take a cruise. And we're gonna be ambushed by monkeys, guys, so kind of running it a longer than usual here. But hey, we will see you in the next episode of Let's Play Majora's Mask, guys. Stay tuned. You guys have a wonderful night. See ya.